China National Offshore Oil Company, which is currently undertaking the oil and gas development projects in the Kingfisher area in Chikube district, has awarded students who performed better in the national examinations of 2023 in Hoima and Chikube districts. Amina Bukenya, the head of corporate affairs at CNOC, said that the program is aimed at fostering education. She said that for 9 years the company has been supporting the education sector and that so far 930 students have been awarded.
This year we are pleased to extend this opportunity to 218 brilliant candidates who have shown remarkable determination and excellence in their studies. Congratulations. At CNOC Uganda, we believe that education is not just a personal achievement, it's a pathway to societal development. The theme for this year's engagement is CNOC Uganda improving education standards in Chikube and Hoima districts by motivating outshining candidates of 2023.
Vincent Alpha Opio, the Chikube District Vice Chairperson, said that there is need for infrastructure development in schools. He added that some learners have to endure long distances to access schools.
One, the number of teachers in our classrooms that we need to recruit more teachers, and we call upon also partners to help us by recruiting more teachers in our classes. And secondly, the distance that learners do travel from their homes to access the facilities, for example, in areas of Changwali, areas of Buhuka and other areas.
CNOC marked 44 million shillings for the scholarships that shall be shared among 78 students in Hoima City, 70 in Hoima District and 70 in Chikube District. The King of Toro, Oyo Nyimbaka Vambaiguru, told his subjects that the HIV and AIDS scourge is real and continues to claim lives. He challenged his subjects to make a contribution towards the fight against HIV and AIDS. He made the remarks during the 29th Mpango celebrations in Fort Fotro yesterday.
Obulwaire bwa siriimu bugaruke bushyaka kandi bweyongere. Kino kireesirwe muno abantu kweba okutekereza ngu obulwaire buno tibukyali bwa maani. Obulwaire bwa siriimu bukyaroho kandi kiswaza kusanga bweyongere. Ninsaba buli muntu weena anyakule hano. Abakuru b'edini, abayobozi bona, abakuru b'amasomero.
Earlier during the day, King Oyo joined his subjects to attend the Thanksgiving service at St. John's Cathedral. Currently, the HIV prevalence in Fort Fotro stands at 14.7%. During the event, he also assured all his subjects on the kingdom land for their safety as quarters. He said a section of people are spreading negative propaganda and fear, noting that Toro Kingdom land belongs to the
people. Nibabiha abantu ngo kama ugenda kubabinga amataka gawe nikigarukamo usaba muntu wena nomu abarabinga abantu amataka gukama
kuri bawezeyire
mbahe
duhe
kabito mbahe mbahe yanjura rweza.
President Yoweri Museveni has said political leaders should be able to accurately diagnose the problems of the people that they lead so that they are able to offer solutions to them. He said a political leader is like a medical doctor who should carry out an accurate diagnosis, because if the diagnosis is wrong, the patient will die.
Because if you are a political leader, you must be like a doctor, you must be like a medical doctor, looking at a patient, and your patient in this case is the society you want to lead. You should say, what is this patient suffering from? What is his problem? you must carry out an accurate diagnosis. Because if the diagnosis is not right, the patient will die.
President Museveni made the remarks while delivering a lecture of opportunity to army officers of the Bangladeshi Armed Forces War Corps at State House in Durban. He explained that the biggest problem Africa faced in the past was the ideological disorientation of leaders before colonialism, a factor that led to underdevelopment and instability.
But the problem was governance. First, we had bad kings who were divided and fighting among themselves. So when the Europeans came, they were able to divide and rule until later when we organized ourselves.
The president also emphasized the importance of the four core principles of National Resistance Movement when it comes to creating prosperity.